roller coaster. You know, we started out 3-0, coming out the gate pretty fast. Then we had a couple losses in a row, a couple close losses that, you know, we felt like a couple of those games we could have pulled out. And we won a couple more and then came into the playoffs on a losing streak. So if that's not the definition of roller coaster, I don't know what is. But the thing is, with a young team, you have to expect ups and downs, and that's exactly what we had. We just have to learn how to win and learn how to win close games and you know, be more disciplined. So I think that's you know, our key going into the offseason.
Darian, you've had the highs of being to a Grey Cup, albeit not winning, the lows of not being a playoff team. Where does this sit?
I mean, if you're not winning a championship, it's still, you know, an all-time low, if you ask me. You know, the older you get, the more you realize that, you know, the chances are winding down for you to get that championship. And, you know, there are no more victories in this. So it's definitely a devastating day, especially we felt like that was a game we could have had. We should be in here game planning right now. But in reality, we just have to build on the things that we did positive and bring it into next year.
You mentioned this is a young team, and coming off that experience you had a couple days ago, is that something that you can use next year, build off of?
No doubt about it. I mean, especially, you know, we saw what it takes to win a playoff game, and that's being disciplined. That's you can't have any mental errors. You can't, you know, have breakdowns on either side of the ball. And I think the young guys will see that. They see how important it is to stay focused for all 60 or 65 plays of a game. So I think guys will be a lot more mature next year, and those mistakes we made this year that cost us in close games, you know, we should be able to come out on top next year.
What was it that made you go to everybody after the game and or as many players as you could and talk to them at that moment? What compelled you to do that?
Just because how close we were. You know, no one pretty much gave us a chance going into that game. But, you know, we saw that, for one, we were capable of winning, and two, we saw that what it took to win and what we did wrong that gave Calgary that game. And I just wanted to let guys know that, you know, hold your head up, because we all see that that was a game we could have won if we did the little things right. So just get your mind right in the offseason and do those little things, and, you know, we'll be able to come out on top next time.
Do you think there are a lot of changes that are going to be needed offensively next year?
Offensively, I don't. You know, I think the main thing we need as an offense is just a nucleus, you know, a group that can beat, a set group that we can have and that we can work with the whole season. I mean, we were always mixing, matching pieces pretty much the whole season. New receiver here each and every week. And, you know, you need that continuity on offense to be explosive. And, you know, that group we had to finish the game the other night, I think that's the group that we can ride with. And you put Jock back in the mix. You know, we're going to be an explosive offense. So if we can keep these guys together, I'm able to work with them from week one of training camp. I mean, we had over 500 yards of offense, and, you know, that's something to build next year.
That's how we win championships. We got to create turnovers. That's been my thing about our defense all year. We've been lacking in turnovers. We've been improving the defense, but there's some things that we could have capitalized on that we didn't take advantage of. And, you know, going into next year, I believe that's something that we're going to improve on.
Next year, you're a free agent, so where do you want to be?
Are you? If I could be here, I'd love to be here. You know, this is a great organization. You know, being a part of the Riders has been huge for me. They take me in and they gave me an opportunity when nobody else has. And, you know, I wouldn't mind being here again another year or years to come.
Is there any NFL thoughts to hopefully try to get a tryout at all?
Hey, if it's out there for me, I mean, it's out there for me. But like I said, I wouldn't mind being here. I would love to be here. I like it out here in Regina. And they took an opportunity and a chance on me. They gave me the opportunity by taking a chance on me, and I would love to do it again.
There's a lot of defensive players that could leave. I mean, is it important to keep a lot of this nucleus together for next season, for the defensive lines?
I mean, yeah. But at the end of the day, with off season and you know, training camp, you can always build that camaraderie again, and just got to make it do, you know. The team is not going to be the same next year, you know. And each year in and year out, different teams change. So, you know, we'll see what happens.
How close do you feel this team is to getting there with BC and Montreal?
So close. I mean, it's the talent in this room is unbelievable. You know, we have good players everywhere in every position that could come in and fill any starter's spot if they go down, you know. So the talent here is amazing, and we got to put it together. We got to mature a little bit.
Coach said that it could have been 11 wins easy enough. What's the difference between an 8-win season and an 11-win season this year?
Just our the maturity level. I would say, you know, just we're a young team, you know, and it's a lot of guys. It's their first year here, and it's just you can kind of tell it's just up and down, you know, and it's like it was like an emotional roller coaster with us this year. So, I mean, based off this, this learning experience off this past season and then going into this next season, I think that we're going to be a crew to wreck with.
Sorry, Tyron, I just got here, but how do you can you sum up what about that game and what happened defensively in the last
game? Just didn't finish. That's it. We didn't finish. And I don't know. I guess they wanted it better than we did.
I guess just your thoughts on your first CFL season.
I thought it was an up and down season in the beginning. You know, I'd say the last six games I kind of caught on and, you know, just try to improve each and every week. For me, it's just coming back next year being better. And, you know, I'm just happy that, you know, next year we definitely got the team to make it all the way.
Do you feel you came back, if you come back next year, that the offense will maybe have a year under their belt together, will be a little more explosive next year?
Most definitely, you know, and, you know, everybody getting down with Darian and pretty much knowing what we need to do. I'm just excited for next year, but, you know, unfortunately we didn't make it this year, but, you know, just through the fire for next year. And I definitely think, like, we're going to be one of the teams to wreck with, you know, come the up-and-coming season.
What do you think you improved most on throughout the year? What was, one of the things that you improved on?
Catching the ball, running routes, you know, getting the terminology down for the game, and, you know, just being more of a leader and not being selfish in so many ways. For the most part, I'm just happy that I still got room for improvement, and, you know, come next year, just do better.
With veterans like Weston Dressler and Chris Getzlaff, who are all stars, what were you able to learn from them maybe about the CFL game?
How to go about the business, you know, pretty much just come out and do the things necessary to each and every week to be great. And, you know, watching Wes and Chris, you know, that was my biggest thing, you know, just trying to learn from them guys. And, you know, they helped me as much as they could. And, you know, I took everything into consideration and, you know, went out there each and every week and try to be great. And for that, you know, I'm just happy that I do get to work with them for next year, too.
How tough a loss was that to take in the West Final?
You know, it was tough. I felt like, you know, as a team, we put it all out there. You know, we gave it our all. Just came down to the last minute, you know, that kind of, you know, we got a little lax, I guess, and you know, it kind of hurt us. But it was hard. It definitely was hard. But for the most part, you know, we just know what we need to do for next year. And like I said before, you know, I'm just excited that we do get a shot to go back next year and work together again.
I think as a defense, we left a lot out there, you know. And like I said, that's maturing. That's getting older, getting smarter, you know, getting to know this game better. And next year, I think as a group, we're all going to be able to do that.
Is that all it takes is to be able to finish games, which was so hard this year?
Yeah, it's finishing games. I think you guys all know that. We lost, I think, four or five games that were within 3 points or 5 points where they scored probably the last 2 minutes. So it's about learning, you know. Like we said, Coach said all year, face yourself with adversity, how to get through that. So.
What about your own personal situation? I think you're going into your option next year. Is this kind of a showcase year for you? Are you thinking that far ahead?
Yeah, you know, I've taken it as a showcase year every year, every day I'm out there, I take it as a showcase day, you know? So it's not going to change for me. I'm, you know, just because it's contract year doesn't mean that, okay, I got to show up and play now. I mean, and I took that upon myself every week I was here that I got to show up and play. So we'll see how it goes next year. And, you know, take a little time. And, you know, look at this game and look at the season and we'll figure it out from there.
Not that you deliver any ultimatums, but do you see it as a year that, hey, I've got to have a bigger role in this team, or, you know, else I can move on?
I'd like to have a bigger role. I mean, I feel like I can start in this league as a free safety, as a defensive back. So I feel like, you know, I definitely can play with this talent up here. So, you know, I feel like the coaching staff and the management knows that too. So it just comes down to seeing how everything fits and seeing how it works out for them.